Hi friends, welcome to Jikesh Adventures. Today we are going to do a very easy recipe and very healthy one. So that is, we are making a sardine paste. So I have made a short video of this on Instagram and I had put it up. But I thought I'll make a nice elaborate video on this and I will show you how to make the sardine paste. So sardines, fish we all know, I have been talking about the benefits of feeding fish to dogs time and again, and it has a tremendous amount of omega-3 fatty acids, and fish oils again are very good for them, for the skin, for hair and coat and stuff like that. So sardine paste, actually what we can do is make it in bulk. And we can freeze it, and as and when you can add it to their meals, or while if you are making some treats for them, or if you are making some like a meal, like a cooked meal how I make, so you can add the sardine paste to that, or just add a spoonful of it to their bowl. So start low, actually, I mean low the quantity, like start with maybe half a tablespoon and then gradually increase the quantity. So there has been a lot of speculation about what do we feed dogs, and we keep getting so many messages, so many DMs about what actually do we feed the girls and what should be fed to the dogs. So what I personally feel is, unless your dog has any medical issue, or if your dog is allergic to any particular ingredient, if your dog is healthy, normal, active, you can feed as much a variety as possible, and try and feeding as much a variety as possible. Like, don't just stick to one food, or don't just stick to one diet. Feeding variety, obviously, you might hear it from so many nutritionists and vets and stuff like that, that keep feeding variety, and that is what I do too. I do feed grains to girls because they have been digesting it well, and I keep changing the grains though. Like, I sometimes I feed rice, sometimes I feed bhakri. So even in bhakri, sometimes I feed jowar, sometimes I feed bajra, sometimes nachni. So keep changing the grains. Vegetables also, there are so many variety of vegetables that you can feed your dogs. If you decide to actually cook, or if you love cooking and if you decide to feed fresh food to your dogs, there is so much that you can do. You can bake stuff, you can dehydrate stuff, you can cook stuff. I mean, the choice is endless. You just have to keep thinking of, you know, be creative and just keep making recipes. So even while giving supplements like oils, don't just stick to one oil. So there is coconut oil, there is flaxseed oil, there is olive oil, or seeds for that matter. There are pumpkin seeds, sunflower seeds, flax seeds. Just keep changing whatever you are adding to your dog's diet time and again. Also, the source of protein, which is the main ingredient, or which should be the main ingredient to be in your dog's bowl, that also needs to be changed. So there's chicken, there's meat, there's duck, fish, of course. So again, if you're feeding fish regularly, there's no need to add salmon oil. So you can stick to the other oils, or so that way you just have to balance it out very well. I think balancing is the key. Even in us humans, I mean, what we used to eat maybe thousands of years ago, we are not eating that now. And we have evolved, the dogs staying with us have evolved, so the diet has to change accordingly. Also, the place that you are staying in matters a lot, the climate matters a lot, and even after feeding all this balanced diet, there is a chance that some dogs genetically have some issues, or environmental factors matter for some. So what I feel is, just go by your instinct always and do what you feel is right for your dog and feed that. So it can be a raw food, it can be a mixed of you know, raw and cooked, it can be semi-cooked or whatever. Like I do feed a mix of raw, semi-cooked and cooked. So, and that has worked very well for the girls. And touch wood, I always keep saying that we don't go so much to the wedding. Like, we have very less wet visits. And that is what I believe in. I mean, I love cooking. One, not so many of you might have that much time to cook for the dogs because of your job and work profile and stuff. But go by your instinct and you know what is right for your dog. So climatic conditions, as I was saying, like it's winter time here in Pune, so it's quite cold. And so for the bhakri, I would not feed jowar. I would rather feed bajra bhakri to the girls. Or I would not feed any frozen foods now. I would, as much as possible, I would try and make something like scrambled eggs or maybe, give them something warm or a bone broth. So too much of anything is bad. As we always keep saying, as our grandparents used to keep saying that, for us also, and the same applies for our dogs also. So anything to be fed in moderation is always good for them, and that is what I believe in, and that is what I want to tell everybody. So let's get back, too much of talk now, let's get back to the sardine paste. So what I have, we don't require too many ingredients here. So what we have here is about 1 kilo of sardines, and I've put them in a bowl so that they are completely immersed in, and put the water quantity also so much that they are completely immersed inside, because we have to boil it for a long time. I've switched on the gas now, and I'm adding about 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric to this. And I'm adding apple cider vinegar. This is with the mother vinegar, and this is natural. So try and find a natural vinegar for your dogs whenever you are using it. And I'm adding about 2 tablespoons of apple cider vinegar to this. So this will basically help break down the bones and absorb it nicely. And we have to boil this till the time the till we see the bones actually breaking down. Now it should take about 25-30 minutes or maybe more. Let's see for this quantity. So the water has almost reduced to half and the fish is nicely done. So I'm going to switch off the gas now and let this cool, and then we'll make a paste. We'll strain all this, and of course the broth also, we don't have to waste it because it's highly nutritious. So we'll use the broth. We'll strain and I'll show you how to use everything that is there. As I keep saying, never let anything go waste. Everything is highly nutritious in there. So this has all cooled down now, and we'll be straining this. Now I have already added ACV to this, so whenever I'll be serving this, I won't be adding extra ACV as an supplement like apple cider vinegar. As I said in the beginning, just make sure whatever you're feeding, make it balanced. So now whatever this is, the bones and the fish is left, we'll be putting it in a jar. And we have to make sure, we have to make a fine paste of it so that the bones anyways have, they will dissolve very well now. And if you find it difficult to make a paste of this, like just as it is, then add a little soup. So I added a little of this broth and it has become a nice smooth paste. Make sure all the bones are broken down and the paste is like real smooth. And now what I have done is, so this you can just store it like that in the refrigerator, but fish paste usually lasts in the refrigerator for 2 to 3 days. So if you are making a bulk batch like this, like how I am making, so I've taken these silicone molds and I'll be storing this in the freezer. So this way it lasts really long, and once done you can just remove it. They won't stick to each other, and then you can store it in a Ziploc bag or any airtight container. So now I'm just going to pour this paste. So this you can add to the diet, like their bowls every day, in their food. Or there's another thing that you can do. I'm going to store a little of this paste in the refrigerator, and tomorrow I'm going to make meatballs for them. So I'm going to shoot that recipe too, and I'll show you how that is done. So the paste you can add to different things. You can make different treats and you can give it to them. There are so many things we can do with the fish paste. And since everyone loves sardines, most of the dogs love sardines. So this is something which you can do, and this goes in the freezer now. If you have this broth left, so what you can do is just add it to their if you have this broth left, what you can do is just add it to their water, just add it to their bowl, like the food bowl, or you can store it and make khichdi in it, or you can boil vegetables in it, or use it as, be as creative as you can. So after freezing they become like this, and then I'm just storing it in a bowl like this. Or if you want, you can store it in a Ziploc bag. If you have a Ziploc bag like this, you can store it inside. So if you have less space in the freezer, they won't stick to each other because now they are frozen. So don't worry about that. And if you want to add it to your dog's diet, just remove it outside for like 10-15 minutes instead of giving frozen like this, and then add it to their meals. So this is our stock that is ready, and what I have kept here, this I had kept in the refrigerator. So the paste has become like this. So you can just scoop out and add 1 tablespoon or whatever the quantity is. Start slow. Anything, any change to your dog's diet, just start with less quantity always, and watch your dog's poop. That is the best way you can find out if your dog is digesting anything well. And this will stay in the refrigerator for 2 to 3 days, and this will go in the freezer for my future batch. And as I said in the beginning of the video, just make sure to feed lots of variety. Consider where you are staying, the place you are staying, the climatic conditions. It's global warming and it's raining in December. So obviously everything is changing. The food that we eat now is changing. So make sure, unless your dog has any medical issue or any allergies, feed as much variety as you can, whether it's vegetables, whether it's fruits, whether it's carbohydrates, and let proteins be a major part of your dog's bowl. So happy cooking, and bye bye and woof woof from Chick Cash Adventures.